there will be no intimacy between us. Because no good deed goes unpunished. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying I would be doing you a good deed by sleeping with you. I'm saying I would be doing you a good deed by the way I slept with you. The type of focus I give could provide you with an entirely new reason to live. Things would happen in this room that you were only half hopeful would happen to you on your honeymoon. In other words, the way you walk out won't be the same way you walked in. And we both know what's gonna happen after that. You're gonna start stalking. I'm talking, even if you ain't prone to wilding, you're gonna call me and text me till I have to leave my cell phone on silent. People gonna see you in my face and wonder why you smiling, and when you begin to feel like I'm not paying you enough attention, that's when you're gonna start to get violent. I know. If I seen it once, I seen it 611 times. And when I start to realize you're getting weird and I start changing my plans, like, never mind, I got something else to do, you're gonna be like, well, who else but you? But it's not you, it's me. Most men think that sex should be expeditious when I believe that the entire experience should be unforgettable and completely religious. I mean, every stroke and every lick should try to change your life as if I have to live vicariously through you. I can't have multiple orgasms, but you can. And I can't make my own legs tremble, but I can change the way you stand. Touch your body all over at once with just one tongue and two hands, and no matter how much I insisted we're just lovers, you're gonna insist that I'm your new man. Like, you can't understand that I don't get down like that. And it's not my fault you didn't know a man can make you sound like that. Push energy through your body from downtown to the back of your brain, but still I don't understand why that means things have to change. And I definitely don't understand why that means you should be legally restrained 50 feet. And no, my children, no, my mother need you to take us out to eat, nor do I need you to come over to my apartment and cook me a meal. I just want us to stick to our original deal, but perhaps I should have been a little bit more forthcoming about how my energy feels, because you've convinced yourself I'm your soulmate when all I've ever wanted to be was a cheap thrill. And I am not the type of man that you would take on vacation, nor am I the man that would ever tell anyone else about our situation. I'm the type of dude that would see you out with another brother and say hi and bye, because I ain't got time for hating. But what I'm saying is, you must be mistaken if you're thinking you should develop a crush. That's why I like to play it safe and tell you from the outset, there will be no intimacy between us.